What's up, guys? Still Venom here, back with another reaction, back with my buddy Novi.
Yes. Some nasty C, Jack.
There's gotta be a better way to say that.
Say it with a C. But yeah, so this is South African rap. So, South African hip hop. So, I'm guessing Ampiano is a genre in South Africa. And this is their hip hop. It's a good song. But I was kind of like just bunching them all together as like Ampiano.
I think we mentioned that last time when we watched. Can't remember the name of it one, but the dude shaking his ass everywhere, the eye patch.
Ruger.
Yeah. I think we talked about that a little bit with him about how there was a hip hop scene and stuff as well, and we had mentioned that it seemed like what we were seeing from him was a lot more Americanized than some of the Ampiano stuff we'd reacted to.
A lot more, and. From this one, it's the same way. It's kind of
maybe that's just a how little the bit more hip hop is. I mean, I feel like hip hop is a very American. I mean, maybe I'm wrong, but I feel like hip hop originated in America.
It did. Yeah.
So I feel like it's a very American thing. So I could see how the production also resembles American production as far as videos go when people are trying to emulate the same genre, you know. I mean, I'm sure all these people are still inspired at some level by, you know, the Tupacs and the Biggies and the Jay-Z's and, you know, all the people in the hip-hop world, you know? I'm guessing there's probably, you know, they're obviously being influenced by probably a lot of the same people that American hip-hop artists are influenced by, so.
Yeah, and then, like, South African music is really taking a come off, and going to, I think a South African woman just got, like, her first music award over here.
Oh, okay.
You're doing pretty good, man. I think it's, like, I forgot.
I think the cost of like producing music and stuff is significantly lowered now. I mean, at least to just get something out there. So I can see how a lot of these places that, you know, it used to be you had to fucking have a whole crew and all this and whatever. Now you could just have a fucking iPhone, a dude that's pretty good at editing and a good song. And honestly, you could put together a video.
The internet has made putting music out there so easy.
Mm-hmm.
It's ridiculous. Like, especially like some of the songs that I've heard. Like, how is this popular?
right.
It's a song called "I'm the Biggest Bird" that has millions of views. And for the life of me, I don't know how.
There's probably more songs I feel that way about than songs I like.
Like, how did this?
Yeah,
but it's the internet, man. Like, you find people who like that, and
well, and kind of like we were with little Mr. Kitty when we were reacting to him. It's like he went. I mean, not that he didn't have any success at all, but his success literally tripled, maybe could like 10 times increased just because he popped off on TikTok for a while and people were using his song as a sound. And so many people discovered him that he literally went from, he had a couple mil maybe views total to now he has over 100 million on just one song. Like,
yeah, that's
the difference crazy. It's just insane how like the internet can, well, and the fact that that song was out for like 8 years
yeah
before that happened, and then all of a sudden, boom,
going back to the top of the charts. Yeah, like that's TikTok has done that to a lot of songs.
Yeah, remember like, I mentioned that with Deftones.
Yeah.
Same thing happened with Deftones.
Crazy how like it was number one when it came out, and then you know, of course, since other people made music, it leaves the charts. 15 years later, it's like number four, number three back on the list because of TikTok.
Right. That's wild. Whatever, man.
I'm about to make a song, put it out there, and just wait for TikTok to do its thing.
Yeah, right. Just put them all out there eventually. It'll do it. All right, let's see what we're getting into with this.
Nasty C Jack.
The Escalade right off the bat.
Definitely Americanized.
Yeah. Within 10 seconds.
Miles Lee shot it.
I used to have Jack in the fridge in the bank. I'm not going back. I had bed bugs, I had roaches and rats. I'm not going back. Making this cheese cannot be this easy. It must be a catch. I'm spending and making it back. So maybe it's balancing that. I used to have Jack in the fridge in the bank. I'm not going back. I had bed bugs, I had roaches and rats. I'm not going back. Making this cheese cannot be this easy. It must be a catch. I'm spending and making it back. So maybe it's balancing that. I used to have.
They know I switch the time zone and bring that shit home. They tipping their hats. I don't want none in return from none of my bros for scratching their backs. Some people wanna be clones, to each his own. Go get you some racks. They going nowhere too fast. Only God knows how they crash. Soon as I found me a window, I got it where I fit in. If I make somebody a widow, she gon' have us some millies. More money, more problems, but fuck it, we'll take it. We used to be broke, it was shitty. Can't be a nobody in my own city. I ride like the mayor, my windows is tinted. These people ain't playing my songs out of pity. They actually genuinely fucking with me. They pay me in tens, twenties, hundreds, fifties. I'm taking it all cash, I ain't picky. Don't give me no hard pass, let me figure it out. I'm not a liability, nigga. I hustle like I got a minute me. Nigga, it's tall racks till infinity.
I used to have Jack in the fridge in the bank. I'm not going back. I had bed bugs, I had roaches and rats. I'm not going back. Making this cheese cannot be this easy. It must be a catch. I'm spending and making it back. So maybe it's balancing that. I used to have Jack in the fridge in the bank. I'm not going back. I had bed bugs, I had roaches and rats. I'm not going back. Making this cheese cannot be this easy. It must be a catch. I'm spending and making it back. So maybe it's balancing that. I used to have.
So, okay, so
today was
no,
a good.
No, don't do that. So he's now, is he from South Africa, or the song was produced in South Africa? Like, this is a.
Yeah.
You said what?
He's from South Africa.
So this was
I believe like he's like in America.
Yeah, I was gonna
like,
say,
yeah, I believe he's like in America now.
I mean, if you wouldn't have said that this was like South African hip hop, I would have just been like, yeah, it's just American hip hop.
That man's in Detroit.
Yeah, I mean, for one, his English is pretty good.
Yeah.
Not saying that the other people's English has been, but he doesn't have really an accent like in when he's talking.
I don't know much about, like, I haven't like dove into him like that, but he's from South Africa.
Okay.
I don't know when he migrated over here.
Mm-hmm.
But he's a South African rapper.
Yeah. I mean, he definitely seems like, I mean, even from his lyricism and everything, he's clearly got he's very fluent in English. To the point that when he talks and when he raps, at least, it doesn't, mm-hmm. He doesn't have an accent at all. So
yeah, maybe when he just like regularly talks, he has his accent.
Right. But yeah, I mean, I thought it was a catchy song.
It's definitely catchy. And low key better. I like it low key better than a lot of the hip hop in America.
Yeah, same.
Americans.
Yeah, like, for sure.
It was kind of like Americanized, like with the jewelry and Escalade and stuff. But
at least it was. But what he was talking about, it made sense though.
Yeah.
Like instead, usually it's like the song is about. Look at all my bitches, and I got the Escalade and money, and look at this. And there was like the visuals of it was that, but what he was talking about was the fact that he used to be broke as a joke, and he used to have fucking nothing, and that's why you're seeing this shit now, is because now he has something. And so to me, that makes that's
more sense.
Yeah, that's I like that message more. Because that message is like, I came from nothing, I built my shit, this is what I got. The other, and that is what happened with those other guys too, but that's not what they're talking about. He said,
skip over all of that.
They're not talking about the struggle, they're talking about their success. This guy is talking about how he's successful struggling. Now, but he was struggling. So, I don't know. I like, yeah.
I even like the beat, man. I like the beat. I like his whole vibe.
I would definitely put this above most American hip hop that I hear nowadays.
Yeah, man. Like, I don't know what it is about South African music, but it's really getting me.
We just need to make a trip at this point, motherfucker. Like,
like want to just listen to nothing but South African music, man.
Do their they like Americans over there? I don't really know much about South Africa.
I don't want to
show up and then be like, everybody just giving us the fucking fingers.
I heard that they do, man. So I don't want to.
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess if you guys like that reaction, then be sure to comment, subscribe, hit the thumbs up, all that good stuff. And we'll catch you next time.
Peace.